take it away. Burn the city, destroy the heart, poison the world. So the white man, the hell he comes to me.
On from the dead, water than I know, I hear the dreadful voices calling, oh, black.
Desiring this man's art and that man's scope, with what I most enjoy, contented least. Yet, in these thoughts, myself,
almost despairing. Happily, I think I'm dead. And then I say, like to the lark at break of day arising from sullen earth, sings hymns at heaven's gates. For thy sweet love remembered such wealth brings, that then I scorn to change my state with kings. my chest. So sleep, little one, till darkness gives light. See till the sun rises up in the sky. There's an old man for the Mississippi. Name it to you, you chaste stars. It is the call.
I never.
the strike and organize, says Joe, I'm with you still. Says Joe, I'm with you still.
Paul Robeson, would you please step forward? Please have a seat at the table and identify yourself by name, residence, and occupation.
My name's Paul Robeson. I'm an actor and singer by occupation and law on the side. My residence is 16 Jumel Terrace, New York City. Sometimes I practice law on the side, but mostly I'm an actor and singer by occupation.
Are you appearing today in response to a subpoena that was delivered upon you by the House Committee on Un-American Activities?
Oh, yes.
And Mr. Robeson, did you file a passport application on July 2, 1954.
Gentlemen, I have filed about 25 in the past 2 months.
All right, now when applying for this passport, were you requested to submit a non-communist affidavit?
Sir, I considered this issue very thoroughly with my counsel and my family and friends. I would not think of signing such an affidavit. It is a complete contradiction to the rights of American citizens.
Are you now a member of the Communist Party?
Oh, please.
Please answer the question.
You know, I really thought I was here about some pastor. All right. It's a legal party, I believe. Like the Republican Party or the Democratic Party.
Was your Communist Party named John Thomas?
My name is Paul Robeson, and what I have to say, I said as Paul Robeson all over the world in public, and that is why I'm here today.
Are you a member of the Communist Party?
In 1946 in California, I stated for the record that I was not a communist. Since that time, I have refused to answer that question, and I refuse now, Mr. Chairman.
You're directed.
Because my vote is nobody's business.
You're directed to answer the question.
Do you want to come to the ballot box when I vote and speak?
Mr. Robeson, you are directed to answer the question.
In the first place, gentlemen, wherever I've been, and I've been many places, the first to die in the battle against fascism has been the communists. And I have laid many a wreath on many a communist grave, and that is not criminal. And in the second place, the Fifth Amendment has nothing to do with criminality. Therefore, I invoke the Fifth Amendment. Mr. Walters, is it not?
Yes.
The Pennsylvania Walter? The author of all the bills designed to keep all kinds of decent people out of this country.
No, only your kind.
Colored people from the West Indies, like myself, from the West Indies and so forth.
No, we're trying to get rid of your kind too, Mr. Robeson. Are you a communist?
I am not on trial today for whether or not I'm a communist. I'm on trial for standing up and fighting for the rights of my people who are still second-class citizens in this country. You want to shut up every Negro who has the courage to stand up and fight for the rights of people.
Mr. Robeson,
do you try to be fair with me? For the rights of his people, for the rights of workers. And I have stood on many a picket line for workers all over the world. And for your Pennsylvania steelworkers, too. And that's why I'm here today. And can you please let me read my statement?
No, you may not. Let me read a statement that you wrote about the Soviet Union. The Soviet Union is the only country I have ever been in where I felt completely at ease.
I suffered no prejudice as I am feeling here today.
What kind of prejudice would that be? You graduated Rutgers Valedictorian and Columbia University, and if I'm not mistaken, I saw you play football at Lehigh.
We beat Lehigh. That's right. Big Red is on my team.
Mr. Robeson, while in Paris in 1949, did you not state that the American Negro would refuse to fight if the United States went to war against the Soviet Union?
I was invited to the Paris Peace Conference, and I wasn't asked there to sing. I was asked there to talk to about 2,000 students from all over the colonial world. I remember saying, I find it inconceivable that the American Negro would go to war on behalf of those who have oppressed them for generations against a country like Russia, which acknowledges the full dignity of the Negro.
Are you now, or have you ever been, a member of the Communist Party?
On many occasions, I have publicly expressed my belief in the principles of scientific socialism. My deep conviction that for all mankind, a socialistic society represents an advance to a higher stage of life. That is, a form of society which is economically, socially, and ethically superior to a system based on production for private profit. the development of human society from tribalism to feudalism to capitalism to socialism is brought about by the needs and aspirations of mankind for a better way of living.
Let me read a statement to you by Thomas Young, a Negro publisher. Mr. Robeson is now so far out of touch with Negro thinking in his everyday emotions, he can no longer speak authoritatively about or for the race.
Mr. Chairman, could I please protest the reading of this statement? If you have Mr. Young here so I can cross-examine him, and I can. Okay, but otherwise, why can't I read my statement?
No, you may not. Mr. Robeson, why did you not just stay in Russia?
Sir, that is a very important question. Because my father was a slave here, and I have many cousins who are sharecroppers here, and I have never been able to measure my own success in terms of myself, and that is why my own success has never meant all that it really should mean, really. And I have sacrificed literally hundreds of thousands, if not millions of dollars, for what I believe in.
Will the photographers please assist from taking photos? It's rather nerve-wracking.
Why, it's all right. I'm used to it. I've been in motion pictures where I can pose and smile. But I cannot smile when I'm talking to you.
The reason why you're no longer in Russia is that you're trying to spread communism here in this country.
Can I read my statement?
No, you may not read that stuff.
I will say before this committee that you will not stop me from speaking out against injustice done to my people here.
I say no, Mr. Rose.
You can brand me a communist, and I will still speak out. You can turn the Negro Nation against me, which you've done, and I will still speak out for the Negro people. You can take away my passport and force me to live on the tyranny of my brother Benjamin, and I will still speak out. You won't stop me from crying out. And if you do succeed in socially, economically, and politically assassinating me, don't think you'll stop me. Because it's not just me. It's the Negro people whom I echo.
I said no.
If you do silence my voice by making me a non-person,
Mr. Rose,
there will be another voice.
I cannot adjourn this any longer. This meeting is adjourned.
I think it should be. I think you should adjourn it forever.
We are black and white together.
they know it. No more of that. I pray you, in your letters, when you shall these unlucky deeds relate, speak of me as I am. Nothing extenuate, nor set down aught in malice. Then must you speak of one that loves